What's up, rude boys? Alright, so today I'm here to talk about how to handle yourself when you're out with your lady and you got fucking haters trying to disrespect you in your face. And guys, this is one of the most important videos that I can make, right? Because, you know, I talk to you guys about getting on your purpose and all these type of things and self-improvement. Well, what does that bring? That brings success. And success brings a higher quality of woman, right? That's the bottom line. And when you're out with this higher quality of woman, you're gonna have haters who wanna disrespect you in your face, as in to show her that they are more man than you. You see, they don't have the game, or the charisma, or have their shit together to attract her like that. So, how are they trying to attract her? Well, they are trying to attract her by showing her that they are more man than you, that you're a punk. So they figure this is our way to attract her. And sometimes, guys, quite frankly, it's not even about them trying to attract her. It's quite actually just hate. I'm jealous of you, so I wanna kick your ass in front of your girl, make you look like a bitch, a punk, punk you in front of your girl, make you look like a bitch. So, the first thing you need to know in this situation, guys, is, and you know, I tell you guys this over and over and over again, to hit the fucking gym. Now, not only is hitting the gym gonna make you more attractive to the opposite sex, guys, at the end of the day, we are men, and we are supposed to protect, alright? At the end of the day, that's what it's all about. So, if you're 160 pounds, and you can't bench press but the bar at the gym, you need to get your ass in the goddamn gym and start lifting some fucking weight, alright? To protect yourself, to protect your fucking family, alright? At the end of the day, at some point, you're gonna have to stand up for yourself. At some point in your life, either you're gonna be a fucking man or you're gonna be a fucking bitch. But some situation, at some point, either it's for you or for your woman, you don't even have to be with a fucking woman. You could just be out by your fucking self and some assholes in there being jerks. Why? Because they don't size your little ass up, they don't size your skinny ass up, and think, well, oh, well, he ain't worth shit, and they just start to bully you. Right? And grown-ups bully too. It ain't just niggas in fucking school. Grown-ass men are fucking bullies too. Women too. Women bully other women. Right? People are just fucking bullies. They see you weak, they fucking wanna try you. They fucking wanna bully you. So the first thing you need to know is you need to be hitting the gym so that you can at least feel comfortable defending yourself. Right? And another thing, one thing you need to know, guys, is a lot of this shit that goes on, guys size you up. Right? When you're out, guys size you up. They ain't over there picking on that 300 pound gorilla over there who look like he been hitting the fucking gym. Over there looking like he got 22 inch arms. Oh, ain't nobody fucking with him. But here comes your little 150 pound ass soaking wet, and oh, they wanna start some problem. But no, they ain't gonna fuck with the 300 pound looking motherfucker. So, the first thing you need to know is you need to start hitting the gym so that you could beef up a little bit. Not only is that gonna make you more attractive to the opposite sex, but it's also gonna keep motherfuckers from trying you. Alright? So, and the next thing you need to know, guys, is either you're a man or you're not. Guys, I'm a rude boy. And when I say a rude boy, I don't just mean in the aspect of fucking bitches. A rude boy is an all-around rude boy. You ain't gonna bitch me, nigga. You're not gonna fucking bitch me, alright? I'm a motherfucking rude boy. I'm a motherfucking man. At the end of the day, I'm a motherfucking man. I stand for anything. You're not gonna play with me. You can beat my ass. You all could beat my ass and jump me right here. But I'm a fight. I'm not gonna run away, nigga. I'm gonna fight. I'm gonna stand up for myself. So, I have a rude boy mindset. Ain't nobody punking me. Period. I'ma die for my fucking self-respect. Alright? I could get my ass beat. I done last fight before. I didn't win every fucking fight that I've ever been in. But at the end of the day, winning every fight is not about being a rude boy. Standing up for yourself, you standing your ground and not being a bitch is what represents a rude boy. Okay? So, you need to get your mind right. If you're afraid of confrontation, you already lost. Alright? because at the end of the day, guys, if you're gonna be going out here and attracting hot chicks, you're gonna have guys who are fucking jealous and wanna fuck with you. And you're gonna have other chicks that probably wanna fuck with her because she hot and she have on a little skimpy dress. And they hating because all the dudes are sweating your woman and shit like this, eh? Everybody needs to know that you're the fucking man, right? So you need to have the mindset of you're not afraid of confrontation. Right? You're not afraid of fucking confrontation. The next thing you need to know is you need to learn rude boy body language. Guys, I always make fucking eye contact. Right? I always and I lock it in. And listen, you can't stare too fucking long before I say something to you. We ain't gonna sit up here and have no fucking staring mash like we fucking in the old western movies or some shit. Like, we're gonna have some kind of shootout in the western world. No. Listen, if I come in a spot and some dude is staring at me, I'ma stare back at him. Ain't no looking at the ground, looking up in the ceiling, looking at my watch. That is the body language that makes them want to try you. Right? Cause you ain't gotta be big, but if guys see you got that alpha male body language, you could be 120 pounds. When guys see that you have that alpha male body language and you ain't looking all timid, looking down on the fucking ground, looking at your shoes and looking at the ceiling and looking at the time and looking at your girl. No, you see these motherfuckers staring at you, you stare back at them. Right? You stare back at them. And before you guys think that it's the venue you're going to, guys, I don't give a fuck where you go. You could go to the most high-end spot that you want to. There is gonna be some assholes in there who are gonna be jokes, who are gonna try to be jokes and shit. I promise you, maybe not all the time, but at some point in time, maybe if you and your girl going out in a dance, I am telling you, at some point in time, you are gonna run into an asshole eventually somewhere. I don't give a fuck how high class you think the event is. It could be a spot where nothing but millionaires go and you have some rich millionaire come over there. Man, I mean to tell you, man, you're with the hottest chick all night. Man, look at all of this. Right in front of your face, alright? So don't even think about you trying to stay out of ghetto spots, because it ain't even about that. You could go wherever you want to. You're gonna have some rich guy who think he's a fucking tough guy try to come over and disrespect you. You check that motherfucker, okay? And guys, chest up, shoulders back. Alright? No timid looking body language. Alright? None of that bullshit. You're a fucking rude boy. You stare them dead in the eyes and you cannot be afraid of confrontation and call yourself a rude boy. That's, listen, that don't even make no fucking sense. Alright? It don't make no sense. You can't call yourself a rude boy and afraid of confrontation. Alright? You gotta be with it. You gotta be about it. And it's not about win or lose, but it's about I'm a fucking man and I'm a stand my ground. Ain't no fucking bitch inside of me. Alright? And here's another thing about this, guys. If you with your girl, anything like this here, and you with her, understand this right here, and this is why I don't think too highly of some women. They enjoy the attention. Yeah, you might get killed. Yeah, you might get your head buff, but it don't matter to her because she's soaking up all this attention. Oh, everybody wants to fight over me. Everybody wants to stare. I'm so hot. She enjoys the attention. So what, you getting disrespected? Ah, who gives a flying fuck? Look at all this attention. Everybody wants to fuck me. I'm so fucking hot. So most women are gonna enjoy the attention. Okay, understand that, guys. Even if you say something like, hey, let's get up out of here, you know, there's a lot of assholes. No, let's stay. She gonna love it. No, let's stay. She gonna wanna stay so that she could soak up some more of this attention. Yeah, you're outnumbered 10 to 1, but that's not none of my concern because everybody wants to fuck me because I'm so fucking hot. You see, this is one of the aspects, because if you are with a woman who genuinely cares about you, she'll try to get you out of that situation. She'll be like, baby, let's get up out of here. Let's go somewhere else. Oh no, not the average woman. I'll say about 90% of women will stay there and soak up all the attention. Oh yeah, they will love it. They'll be, who gives a fuck if it's 20 Africans over there standing up on the fucking table ready to whoop your ass for me? Oh, who gives a flying fuck as long as I get some more attention, right? Now guys, if you're with a chick and she somehow, like, encouraging it, like, looking at the guy and smiling, like, encouraging it and all this and that and the other. You with a disrespectful bitch, and you don't show the weakness for her to do that, because now she's fucking with you, right? So guys, with all the stuff that I teach you about shit tests and confidence tests, it's to prevent you from getting to this position. At this point, she saw insecurities in you, and now she's giving you a fucking test. Never react to this shit, because she could not even want them dudes, she could just be testing you. So whenever you're with a girl like this, and let's just say you're not out and there's some disrespectful guy. Let's just say that you and your girl went out for a drink, and there's some male bartender, and she's coming over, and you could tell that she's flirting with him a little bit. And he's kind of flirting, but never say nothing in that situation. Never say nothing, that is a fucking test. No, you shouldn't even be in this situation. The reason why you're in this situation here is because she saw insecurities. She saw jealous tendencies, and this is what women do to poke at your insecurities a little bit more. And it does no good to say anything about it. When I say it does no good to say anything about it, because she is gonna make it seem like it's all in your fucking head that you see her floating with this dude. She is gonna swear up and down. She is gonna make you feel like you're crazy that you don't see it. So it does no good. So just ignore it, because she's not even interested in this dude. It's all about poking at your insecurities. So, what does this do, guys? What does this do when you're out with your girl and there's this one guy and maybe the bartender, but since, let's say, it's not a confrontational situation, but you can tell there's a little flirting going on. What does this do? This keeps her up here, up high, and this keeps you below her, and now you're chasing her validation. Alright, so in this situation, you've basically put her on the pedestal, alright? So now she's got you in a flux, constantly worrying, alright? So this situation is, don't even say nothing. If you say something, you care a little too much, and you're weak. If you don't say nothing, now, to her, it looks like if you don't even give a shit. Which means that you're not pussy whipped, you're not weak for her. So you see, the whole thing is, women do shit like this here, is they always try to test to see how pussy whipped you are. A man who is pussy whipped, he's gonna say something. Because the mere thought of another guy even talking to his girl or even looking at his girl draws him insecurities. A man that is secure of himself and feels like he is the prize ain't gonna say nothing in that situation, because in his head he thinking like, if you wanna leave me for this damn chump, well, you go ahead. You go right ahead. I am the fucking prize. I'm on my purpose. I'm hitting the gym. I got bitches lined up from here to Jericho. So, if you wanna leave me for this dude up here who pouring your drinks, well, you go right ahead. You guys, you see the difference? You see why women search for these insecurities? Because a pussy whipped dude has essentially said, you're worth more than me. I am lucky to have you. And now the mere thought of another dude, a confident man don't feel like if no man, no other man is even capable of pulling you away from him. So he don't even worry about it. I'm not even worried about it, because I know ain't no other man even capable of pulling you away from me. I'm that fucking bad, alright? So, you need to remember that if you're out with your girl and she's going back and forth with these little flirts, you need to just remember that all this shit is a test, alright? And if you fail this test, guys, there is a good chance that you're gonna be getting a breakup very soon, alright? Because now you've put her on the pedestal, and a woman wants a man she could look up to, not a man who she has to look down to. A man she looks up to knows, can't no man take you away from me, alright? You just told, essentially what you just did, you just told her you are worth more than me, alright? Now, let's get back to the confrontation situation. Alright, now, if you're in the confrontation situation and you're with your woman and there's a man who's obviously disrespectful, guys, you have to stand up. You're gonna lose your fucking woman if you don't stand up. She cannot respect you. A woman gotta feel safe with you, alright? So, if a guy is disrespecting you, you gotta get your ass whooped, alright? I don't care. Whatever it is you have to do, you gotta get your ass whooped. Now, listen. You don't got to go over there swinging, but you got to stand up. You got to go over there and say, hey man, you have a fucking problem or something. Alright, you got a fucking problem. No woman is not going to respect you, look at you the same, because essentially, if someone was to come up and threaten her, you couldn't protect her. You're a fucking bitch. Alright, part of the thing why women look into us guys is because they look at you and they say, this is my protector. I don't have to fight, my man gonna fight my battles for me. And our family, kids too. Alright? So, essentially she knows that if you ain't gonna stand up for yourself, she knows you're not gonna stand up for her. You just got punked for your own honor. Alright? And you didn't even stand up for your own honor. You're gonna stand up for hers. Alright? So, she gonna lose attraction. Because now she don't even feel safe with you. So some dude could just come and smack her on the ass. Smack her in the face, and she knows you ain't gonna do shit. So, you're gonna lose your woman if you don't fucking say something or stand up or at least let motherfuckers know there's gonna be some fucking problems in here if this shit don't stop. Now guys, let me tell you something. You could learn all the fucking strategies you want. You could watch as many of these videos that you want. But one thing I can't give you is the rude boy mindset. Guys, we ain't afraid of confrontation. With nobody, alright? Yo guys, I always stand up for myself. I ain't gonna take no shit from nobody. My boss, not my girl, nobody. The landlord, whoever, I'm not gonna take nobody's shit. I live in my Jeep before I take some shit from somebody, okay? That is the road boy mindset. Alright? And I ain't gonna be going out nowhere with my girl and some assholes over there disrespecting me. And listen guys, I'm not telling you guys to go and get yourself in no trouble, but what I am telling you is if this situation comes and you don't stand up for yourself and you don't respect yourself enough to make a stand for yourself, you can't call yourself a rude boy. Alright, so that's the bottom line. Just say, hey man, I ain't gonna do no confrontation and I'm a nice guy. That's fine guys, be that. I'm proud, but don't call yourself a rude boy if some guy is gonna disrespect you in front of your woman and you just walk away and don't say nothing, alright? You can do that, but it's your choice. Alright? And I'm not telling none of you guys to go get in trouble. You could do what the fuck you want to do. I don't give a fuck if you let some other guy come and smack your woman on the ass and finger her in the asshole. It don't make me no different. I'm just telling you what the fuck I'm gonna do, alright? So, that's the bottom line, guys. So, at the end of the day, I'm a fucking rude boy. I don't just call myself a rude boy because it sounds cool. No, I'm not afraid of confrontation, alright? I'm not afraid of confrontation. First, I'm gonna let you know that this bullshit is gonna stop, and if it don't stop, we are gonna have a fucking problem. And that is what it is. Eye contact, guys. Body up, shoulders back. Alright? Don't be looking dumb, looking on the wall, looking fucking timid. What's on the fucking wall? Ain't nothing on the fucking wall. You look at them motherfuckers in the face and you let them motherfuckers know. More than likely. Let me tell you something guys. Bullies are fucking pussies. If you ever run into some real tough guys, they don't fuck with people. Alright? I know guys who run coke for a living and shoot other coke dealers and shit. And they are the nicest guys in the world. And then you have some wannabes over here, you know, and they picked up some barbells one day in the gym. Because they feel they born in the ghetto and they feel now they're some fucking tough guys. And they wanna bully every fucking body. You see, when you make eye contact with them motherfuckers, they're pussies any fucking way. They're looking for people weaker than them so they can pick on them because they ain't over there picking on that 300-pound bodybuilder over there against the fucking wall. They wanna pick on you because maybe you're small and you're by yourself, alright? So understand that most of them are pussies and most of them don't even like confrontation anyway. What they're looking for is somebody who's got weaker body language than them so that they can pick on disrespect. And when you look them in the eyes, they don't want no fucking problems, no way, right? They hate confrontation deep down. Guys, I'ma tell you something. I used to be on the wrong side of the law at one point in time in my life, and now I have turned my life around, so I don't hold them kind of meditations anymore. Now, let's say I was to get in confrontation with a guy who is considered a bully. You know why he is considered the bully and not me? The reason I am not going around bullying people is out of fear that I will be awakening a part of myself that I fear becoming, so which is why I turned my life around in the first place. Now the bully is bullying out of fear that he is not the thing that I am trying to avoid being. So guys, you need to understand that guys who act like this, they are really pussyholes deep down, and if you stand your ground, they really genuinely don't want no confrontation. What they are really looking for is to see if you back down. And now, oh, they wanna be tough. But if you stand your ground, you'll see that, oh, they don't want no fucking problem. And understand that you're a woman. And I'm not gonna say all women, but most women, they will enjoy the attention. Even if you're getting your ass beat, she gonna enjoy the attention. This is just women, this is just how they are. She'll be like, ooh, everybody want me in here tonight. Right? So, that's just the way it is, guys. Anyway, I don't wanna keep this video too fucking long. But guys, stand your fucking ground. This is rude boy lifestyle, this is not nice guy lifestyle. Right? You stand your fucking ground. Look them motherfuckers dead in the eyes. Okay, so, may I go catch up with you later. Respect.